Kidiogo presents Genius Insight, The Influence of Social Norms, with Dr. Milan Labrie. Without our adherence to social norms marketing would not nor could not be an effective form of persuasion. But what are social norms, you may ask? Social norms are simply the accepted standard that we have for behavior within society and our social groups, and we tend to look at them as unwritten rules. An example of this is when we see an elderly person or a pregnant woman on public transportation, we should give up our seat for them. We accept these standards with our family, friends, work colleagues, class members, etc. We tend to be, in most cases, accountable to these norms. Therefore, they are powerful ways to understand and predict the behavior of individuals and the collective. Because social norms are such powerful indicators of behavior, marketers can use these norms or known predictable behaviors as tools of influence and persuasion using something called social norms marketing theory. It is based on the idea that people's behaviors can be predicted by what they perceive as normal or usual. For example, if university students believe that most of their peers smoke, they are more likely to smoke. But by using social norms marketing, people understand that the majority of their peers do not smoke, potentially leading them to avoid smoking because people actively strive to emulate what they believe is typical of their peers. As with everything, this comes with a set of challenges. Why? Well, the thing is, we as humans tend to misjudge what is actually the norm. Why? Well, for many reasons. But as the saying goes, birds of a feather flock together. This simply means that we tend to see, do, read, look at, hang out with those people or things that confirm our beliefs. In psychology, we call this confirmation bias, but we'll save this concept for another time. The point is, we surround ourselves with what we believe to be true. So as you can imagine, it can get pretty sticky when, well, you just are flat out not right. Social norms marketing uses a broader lens to change our beliefs or attitudes to inform us of what the majority is doing. Marketers know how to create an environment or narrative showing you how most people act in an effort to get you, the consumer, to emulate what you believe is typical of your peers. Simply put, they want you to follow the crowd, buy what everyone else is buying, and think like the collective. To change the collective perspective, marketers can use something called positive community norms. Positive community norms tend to focus on creating media campaigns to address normative misperceptions across layers of a community. This principle targets several audiences surrounding a specific issue or concern to create lasting cultural transformation. This is done by addressing community issues, focusing on positive, healthy norms and behaviors, and reducing misperceptions. For example, suppose you wanted to address underage drinking. Maybe there's a misperception that there is a massive problem in your community. In that case, you might focus your efforts on children, parents, and schools, telling them something like, 99% of students and parents disapprove of drinking. This shows a more positive norm and inspires children to do what their peers are doing, not drink. But in addition to positive community norms, marketers also use normative messages. Normative messages seek to influence a behavioral change. The goal is to get people to conform so they feel liked or accepted by their peers. For example, your favorite supermarket might put up a sign that states, "Shoppers in this store believe that reusing shopping bags is a worthwhile way to help the environment. We thank you for helping the environment and continuing to reuse your bags." This message suggests that it's normal to use a reusable bag. As such, if you don't, you won't be liked or accepted by the other people who shop in that market. There is a lot of information floating around in the world, and it gets pretty challenging remembering everything. I'm sure this is something you've experienced at some point as a student, as you've prepared for an exam. There are millions of products out there for consumers to choose from, and it's hard to decide one over the other. But there's a trick, a key, if you will, that marketers use to get people to remember all the information that you are bombarded with. It is the use of memory aids. Good marketers aim to connect your mind to their product, information, or idea by using a catchy symbol, jingle, slogan, or character image. Have you ever heard any of the following? Give a hoot, don't pollute. Takes a lickin' and keeps on tickin'. Like a good neighbor. I'm stuck on Band-Aids. More than likely, one of these triggers something in your brain because they use memory aids. These are a vital part of successful marketing and getting your message or product at the forefront of people's minds. But day to day, we also use these to remember names, equations, formulas, and really all sorts of information. Let me take you back to elementary school with the following example. Roy G. Biv. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, violet. Yep, these are the colors of the rainbow. As we wrap up this session, let's look at two final terms. One of the most powerful messages that we can receive is something called a descriptive norm. Descriptive norms involve our perception of what behaviors are typically performed. These norms are based on the observation of those and the environment around you. Simply, it is what we do. Therefore, it is sometimes referred to as the do norm. Here's an example. We see a lot of litter on the ground during a walk, so our perception is, that's what people do, they litter. When you see the trash on the ground, you may be more inclined to litter as well. I mean, if they're doing it, then you can do it too. On the other hand, an injunctive norm transmits group approval about a particular behavior. It dictates how an individual should behave. In more simple terms, it is what we approve or disapprove of. This is something referred to as the don't norm. As an example, most of us don't litter because it is a social norm dictating our behavior. Therefore, most people think that littering is wrong and just don't do it. Although littering is not exactly the best example, as hopefully most of us don't litter regardless of our external cues, the takeaway here is that of the two norms, descriptive norms are far more potent as actions speak louder than words. So let's take a moment to review. Social norms are simply the accepted standards that we have for behavior within society or a group, and they tend to be what we consider unwritten rules. Social norms marketing uses a broader lens to change our beliefs or attitudes to inform us of what the majority is doing. Positive community norms tend to focus on creating media campaigns to address normative misperceptions across layers of a community. Normative messages seek to influence a behavior change. The goal is to get people to conform so they feel liked or accepted by their peers. Memory aids are used to remember names, equations, formulas, and all sorts of different kinds of information. Descriptive norms involve our perception of what behaviors are typically performed. These norms are based on observation of those and the environment around you. It's something referred to as the do norm. Injunctive norms transmit group approval about a particular behavior. It dictates how an individual should behave. This is sometimes referred to as the don't norm. Well, that's all for this episode. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to like and subscribe to our channel so you don't miss the next Genius Insight. Thank you for joining me, and I'll see you next time.